गुड आफ्टरनून, नमस्कार। आदरणीय कॉलेज की प्राचार्य डॉक्टर छाया पांसे मैम एवं सीनियर एवं जूनियर कॉलेज के वाइस प्रिंसिपल तथा आईक्यूएसी कोऑर्डिनेटर डॉक्टर वैशाली मैडम तथा सभी प्रतिभागियों का आईक्यूएसी के द्वारा आयोजित कार्यशाला के चौथे दिवस में आप सभी का स्वागत है। कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ाते हुए मैं प्रिंसिपल मैडम से आग्रह करती हूँ कि वे आज की कार्यशाला पर अपनी बात रखें। प्रिंसिपल मैम।
थैंक यू उषा जी। रिस्पेक्टेड वाइस प्रिंसिपल्स डॉक्टर पाठक, डॉक्टर मैथिली मुकुंद, डॉक्टर आचार्य, आई हैव गिवन ऑल डॉक्टर्स डिग्री, इट्स सो यूज्ड टू टॉकिंग। आईक्यूएसी कोऑर्डिनेटर डॉक्टर वैशाली सोमनी, टुडेज रिसोर्स पर्सन डॉक्टर विनीता जैन एंड टीचर पार्टिसिपेंट्स। Today we are at the last day of our capacity building workshop. We have tried to cover most of the platforms which will help you in e-learning. Our aim was that MD college teachers should have a good quality in teaching, so students are attracted more and more. As online teaching is new to everybody, we all will have to experiment and better ourselves. But even before experimenting, we thought it was ideal to give you to show you a platform where we can learn. And this is in this experimenting, something we can learn from you, something you can learn from me, and it is going to be a sharing. While I am experimenting, I can find something good. While you are experimenting, you can find something good and we can do good. But at the same time, we should not forget that library resources are the brain of any educational institute, and so is our library also brain for everybody, for you, for me and our students. And luckily we have many resources in the library where we can go online. We can sit at home, taking the login ID from Dr. Vinita Jain, and we can access all the library from sitting at home at the tip of your finger. And Vinita Jain has already every year taking this for the students and the teachers. Now it is the need of our, I think all the teachers will listen carefully to Vinita Madam's talk today. And we will make the best use of library resources sitting here at home. Vinita Madam, welcome you once again to our own college platform, and we are looking forward to listen how we can make the best of the library sitting at home. And once again, IQAC, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. इसके पहले के 3 दिन हमने Google Classroom तथा Google Form एवं यूज ऑफ जूम एवं पेन टैबलेट के बारे में देखा। आज के वर्कशॉप का विषय है यूज ऑफ ऑनलाइन लाइब्रेरी रिसोर्सेज बाय डॉक्टर विनीता जैन मैडम। विनीता मैडम पिछले 29 वर्षों से एमडी कॉलेज में बतौर सीनियर लाइब्रेरियन कार्यरत है। मैडम डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी इनोवेशन और एप्लीकेशन पर इनकी गहरी रुचि रही है और इस पर इन्होंने कई काम भी किए हैं। कई पुरस्कारों से सम्मानित है, जिनमें से बेस्ट लाइब्रेरियन अवार्ड by Bombay Science Association in 2018, Best Paper Presentation Award by University Library Website in Mumbai Region, successfully completed UGC Minor Project, 1 month training course on Building Sustainable Libraries International Program in USA. आपके कई पत्र पत्रिकाओं एवं किताबों में आपके शोध आलेख प्रकाशित है। मैं यदि मैम का परिचय देने जाऊं तो शायद समय कम पड़ जाए। मैम कई पुरस्कारों से जहाँ समय को देखते हुए सभी का मैं नाम नहीं ले पा रही हूँ, लेकिन हम आज बहुत ही गौरवान्वित मैं महसूस कर रही हूँ कि मुझे मैम का परिचय देने का सौभाग्य प्राप्त हुआ है। ज्यादा समय न लेते हुए मैं डॉक्टर विनीता जैन मैडम से आग्रह करती हूँ कि वे आज के विषय को लेकर अपनी बात रखे। मुझे पूरी उम्मीद है कि हम अवश्य जितने भी प्रतिभागी हैं हम इसका पूरी तरह से फायदा उठाएंगे। मैं विनीता मैडम से को आमंत्रित करती हूँ। एक बार पुनः आप सभी का स्वागत है, धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू।
before starting the session, let me thank the principal Pansi ma'am and Vaishali madam for giving me an opportunity to take this session online. I will try to cover maximum information about online library resources. Please stay with me till the end. So, use of online library resources. As we all know that library is closed completely and all the physical resources are not accessible to anyone. But now everybody is going online and they have to prepare the online content all the time for the teaching learning purpose. So I am just going to show some of the library resources which is available in our library through web OPEC and also other resources which is available free on web. So everybody is talking about what is online. So online, when you say online, there is an internet word will come in mind. So internet is an ocean of information. So what we are using online information is just a 5%, that is surface web, 4 to 5%. All the social media sites are using. So we are also using this 5% of information. Deep web is 90%, about 90% of the information where we require the credential to log in. This is not free and it is not available directly through search engine. All the banking site, research paper, which is paid subscription, medical records, these are available under deep web. So these covers 90% of the internet search. Now coming to the dark web. Dark web is illegal information. It can browse by Tor browser only. And all the cyber criminal activities and fraud is coming under this dark web. So dear friends, please stay online with security and always do online activity with utmost care. Today, these are the contents I'm going to cover. So I'll just try to cover as many as contents. Library homepage, I'll show you e-resources. Mobile apps, MHRD initiatives, spoken tutorials, ebooks, plagiarism checker, UGC care list, institutional repository, content management tool, copyright free images, and some other videos I just wanted to cover today. This is library page. When you click on MD College website, there is a library button. So you click, then library website will open. So whatever is there in the library website, you can use it because it is available online anywhere. So this is the library page. Just scroll down a little bit. This is quick access link. These links you can use it. So first of all, I'm just going to show you web OPEC. This is library catalog. We have 45,000 books in the library. So all these catalog, all these books list are available here. When you see this item type, here you can check out the collection. This number of distinct title is unique title and number of copies. So total 25,580 books in senior college we have. We have some e-books, we have some journal article, donated books, and some senior college textbooks. So this is overall our library collection. You can access this web OPEC through mobile also. If you scan QR code through your mobile, you can access it. I just show you if this will work fast. See, this is the QR code. I just scan it. And this web OPEC will open your mobile phone also. So you can check anytime library catalog in your phone also, or otherwise enter with the internet connection. So this search is like Google search only. When you put some search here, I just put one search, ecology. We want to search some books on ecology. Go to search. And then advanced search option is also there. So I searched this term ecology. So 134 books list has come. And this this highlight word is wherever I put the search term, this word is highlighted. So these are 134 books available in our library. So the status is on shelf. That means this book is available in the library. If it is issued to somebody else, then here it will show issued. If it is withdrawn, then it will show withdrawn here. And this is the location that in the zoology rack we have kept this book. This is the accession number, this is the call number, and the current location, it's in main library. So this is how our catalog and some of the books that this content page is also available. This QR code is for each and every book. If you want to search this book, Biological Diversity, you can just scan the QR code and save this search in your mobile. When you come back to the library, you can ask that this we require this book. So that will be easier for you. Now, 134 books, you need not to require. So you just wanted to have one list of this book. So you just click it here, all pages to basket. And then after that, show my basket. See, all 134 books list will come here. Some of the books have duplicate titles. So if you don't want, then you can remove some of the titles and you can make the bibliography. So I'll just remove some of the titles and I'll show you how to make the bibliography. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I just remove the duplicate titles and then make the bibliography. See, this is bibliography. So after selecting this, you just click it here, bibliography. This is the list, 134 list, but I have selected this 112. So this 112 books list have come. Now you can take a printout of this list. Whether you can take printout or you can save it in PDF file. You can download this in your PC also. So this is how you can search the books. Because library is not accessible, as per your syllabus, you can search these books and make the bibliography chapter wise or syllabus wise. So this will be helpful for you when college reopens. Now one more feature is My Info. You can check your record anytime. This is my record. The password is capital member. The password is same for all of them. This is my record that my name is displayed here and I have taken one book. So whatever books you have taken, that will display here. I have taken on 22nd December and it is due on 30th April. Status is issued. If students have taken, then here fine will also display. So anyone can check out your borrower list. Now I just log out. You can also check out, but right now it is not accessible. The problem is that we have set the membership end deadline on 20th May to 2020. So if you check it now, that membership will expire, this message will come. So once we go back to the library and then we will start activate your account, then you can search anytime. New arrivals. We have set the rule of 30 days new arrivals books. Now, due to lockdown, we have not entered any of the single book. Otherwise, all 30 books will display here, latest 30 books. Okay. Active user threes. That means 3 persons are using at a time this OPEC right now. and hits is 46,900, 469,516. That means this how many times we have hit the search of this web opaque. So this number will count for the NAC purpose. When we go to advanced search, you can search through, if I search the book on cell biology, you can narrow down your search by title wise, anywhere in the field or the exactly matches field. These are the collection type. If you want to search in this UGC book or textbook or CD or donated books, so that also you can search. Publication year also, if you just wanted to search only latest books, so then you can put here, yeah. So let's see if some books are displayed. Yeah. So I have put a search 2010 to 2020. So 7 books on cell biology have come. So this is also, you can prepare this list bibliography and you can use it chapter wise bibliography. Now this is the journals list. We are subscribing 75 journals in the library. These are the journals list. And whatever issue we have received on which date, that will also display here. So if you are looking for any of the new journals, you can check out whether it has come to the library or not. You can select any of this and then detail will come. Like India Today, English, we select. So all the India Today issues will display here and then the accession number of this. If it is issued by somebody, then it will come here, the borrower ID number, if it is issued to someone. So these are the features of Web OPAC. Overall, 45,000 books are listed here. Latest 10 items means whatever we entered every day in the library. So last 10 items will display here. So you can check anytime over library catalog that what is new in the library. So these 10 items will be here and you can click and you can come back to the library and you can ask that this book has, new book has come in the library and we want this book. Okay, so this is all about Web OPAC. This is the Web OPAC page, syllabus. Earlier we used to download all the syllabus class-wise and then put it on our website, but then it will take a lot of space. So we just give the link, a Mumbai University link in our website for the syllabus. So you can check out anytime the syllabus, whenever this is updated syllabus. See, the syllabus is there. Faculty of Commerce, all the syllabus, revised syllabus, SYBCOM. And they, with the syllabus, they have the reference books list also. So anytime you can check online the syllabus. This is the question paper, old question paper. This link is also given in the library website. Old question paper, 18, 19, 17, 18, year-wise they have arranged 2019 first half. When you click here, that zip file will come and you can download the zip file with all the class-wise that question paper will be available here. So this also you can refer anytime while preparing the questions, or you can tell the students to check. E-resources. These are the e-resources, paid e-resources, UGC Enlist and Delnet. These two database we have subscribed in the library and others are free. So we'll take up one by one. E-newspaper. We have given the link of e-newspaper and the library website. So you can click e-newspaper anyone and then you can read every day online newspaper. Some of the papers, they want the login ID. So you just log in it and then you can access the newspaper every day. This is UGC NLIST database that we have subscribed. As we are the institutional members, everybody, all the staff members have got the login ID and password. So I have just put my login ID and password, and I will show you how to use it. These are the e-resources list, subscribed e-journals. So these many titles are accessible full text through UGC NLIST. And these titles are not available free on Google. Because we paid subscription to NLIST, that is why we can get access. I'll just show you one or two examples. McGraw-Hill eBooks. See this. Because we have going through the database in FlipNet, that is why we are getting this access, ProQuest eBook Central. Otherwise, this database is very expensive. So, and you will not get the access. Suppose we search this book. This book you can read online, you can download the book. You can download all pages, require third-party software. Have an active download that expires in 6 days and 9 hours. If you download this book, it will disappear in 6 days. You can download PDF chapter also. You can share this link to a book. You can save to bookshelf also with your login ID. Okay. And when you scroll down, you will get the title page, copyright, about the author's content. So many books are, millions of books are available online. So please check the content first. And if it is useful for you, if you think that this is very good for me, then you just go ahead. Otherwise, you just leave it. So this is the content page. If something is good for you, then you can use it. Here is that facility that you can highlight also, and you can save that. And that highlight, this part you can use later also. You can highlight and you can save this. If you log in, you can download this book, you can take printout, but printout is only for the limited pages. Now next, I will show this JSTOR. See here also, this is accessed by NLIST member institution. Because some of the journals are not available free, as we are the institutional members, we will get it through here. So you can search any of the book here. I just put a search digital literacy. Title. The 17,245 search result. We can narrow down this search by putting this year wise. Latest books only we require. And you apply. So instead of 17,000, this 611 books will come. You can again narrow down the research search by journals only, book chapter only, or research only. And this, you can download it, you can save it, you can cite this item. So for researcher, this database is very useful. I will not show the full download because it will take some time. And this is all free. Okay. So these all are the databases we can access through this Indian journals. These Indian journals are also academic journals. Many are listed in UGC CAIR list. So if you want to publish any of the paper, you can check out this Indian journals. Some are open access, some are not. Even Indian Journal of Horticulture, we'll just check it. This is the detail. If you want to publish your paper, then you have to subscribe it. Otherwise, some of the contents you can check free. This is the current issue. These are the, this you can download it anytime. Okay. PDF file is there. You can download. Okay, this will take a lot of time. Yeah, download it. Okay. So lot of online material is available for you, especially for researchers and faculty members, those who are doing active research. World ebook library, this is not available right now, and Taylor Francis ebooks. So all these you can check out, each and every feature of this and list. Master file analyst user, because we have created all the user ID to all the students and teachers, I have created one link on the library page also. Just 1 minute. User statistics. This user statistics is very, very important for the NAC point of view. We have to upload this file in NAC. This is, I have downloaded on 3rd January for 1 year data. So 1 year only this much is the uses. This file, actual file, we have to download, give it to the NAC. So that is why all the teachers and all the students should use NList maximum, because this user statistics will not be manipulated, it will generated automatically. So I have given one page on the library site where students are not having NList record, they can fill the form and then we will generate the NList user ID and password. This is another database, Delnet. Right now this will not work because this database is IP based address, and this is accessible only within the institution and campus only. So that is why I cannot show you detail, but these are the database. US patent full text is accessible. Interlibrary loan facility also they will give through Delnet. Next, Swayam portal. Study webs of active learning for young aspiring minds. This is swayam.gov.in. All the students, you just encourage all the students to take one course at least in a year. So that gives weightage to the institution. You have to just sign in here and check the complete course catalog, all, and these are the subject wise education. I just show you the education, teacher education, whatever is there in the teacher education. Let's check it. See, these are the courses available now. Academic and research report writing. 8 weeks starts on 20th July. Exam is on 15th November and enrollment ends on 31st July. So if you all can want to join, you can join this right now. This starting date is 20th July. So how to join it? First you log in and create your login ID and password. And then you just click it here and then join. You can check the content, what is there in that. And then the syllabus, course layout also, it is available. When you prepare the e-content, e-modules as per the 4 quadrants, this will be very helpful. So course layout, you just check out the course layout and then you can join the course. If you think that this is not my cup of tea, you just leave it and then search some another course. So everything is given here, 8-week course, and you just join it. 4,560 people have already joined, so you can also join this. Because I have not put the login ID and password, so that's why it's not coming. Okay. Let me check if I remember my password. I'm sorry, I have not remember my password. This is nptel.ac.in. You can check latest updates on NPTEL website. Faculty initiative, NPTEL workshop, internship. Just show you this faculty initiatives. This is conducted by AICTE. Number of weeks courses. And if you complete this course, then what credit you will get? Half FDP of 1 week. So that's how you calculate as per the CAS. These are the resources, courses. You can check anytime all these resources. This is free on the net. You can check by video course, web course. And you can join anytime. NPTEL especially for technical subjects. And you can watch these videos and give the assignment. Once you join the course, then only you can give the assignment. Otherwise, you can watch on YouTube just to increase your knowledge. Virtual lab. Virtual lab, all the IITs, this is the MHRD initiative, virtual lab. To provide remote access to lab in various disciplines of science and engineering subject. For example, I'll just take one example of this chemical science and then select the inorganic chemistry under that and under that soil analysis. So they have given the lab experiment that you can use for teaching learning purpose. You can tell the students also.
Seven buffer solution. Place the beaker below the pH electrode and dip the electrode into the
electrode. Very well, they have explained the lab experiment. So you just go through your subject wise. This is for science discipline. And then you can make use for your students. This is Vidwan database. It's on InfimNet. All the faculty members should create their profile under this Vidwan database. This will be very useful to showcase your research to globally. Here you go login as expert and you can login it. You can search subject wise any of the experts. So these many all the postgraduate are also can join this. I just show one example, social science. Dr. Jagdish Arora, he is the ex director of InfimNet, is with one expert ID is number one. Just check this view profile, just wanted to show you this. These are the publication. You can go to your to profile and give your expertise, information, experience, qualification, honors, awards, members in committee, research projects, and then whatever the co-author in your publication, this will also reflect here with the year wise. When you create your ID on Vidwan database, automatically that data will fetch if you have your paper on Scopus ID also, or Google Scholar also, or Microsoft Academic Search also. So this is also very useful. You all can create your ID, your profile. When you log in and edit profile, there is one option coming here that download CV. So if you update all your profile, automatically your CV will generate with all the publications, with all the awards and recognitions, that automatically your CV will generate. So if you keep on updating this Vidwan database, your CV will be updated anytime you can take it. And this will be all over India database. You can go for collaborative research also. I have created my profile also, I will show. Yeah, this is my profile on the Vidwan database. Yeah, these are the publications, co-author network, and all these details. Because I don't have any Scopus publication which is listed there, so only the Google Scholar ID will come here. This is fetched automatically once you add your data in this. This Google Scholar ID. Yeah, so this once you create over there, this data will automatically take. Why Vidwan profile is required? Showcase your expertise to the research community, funding agency, policy makers, linking to other database and external resources. And why institution, how institution will benefit if you create your Vidwan database? Find experts in a given research area and geographical area. Right now we are doing all teachers research, but we are just not organizing it. If we create a profile in Vidwan database, through the institution name, everything, all the teachers profile will come here, and that gives the visibility to the institution as well as the research scholars also. You can identify funding opportunities and associated experts. You can check out other profiles and you have the collaboration for the research. Indicate, it is online Union Catalog of Indian Universities. This is also MHRD initiative. All the Indian books are listed here. You can search any of the books, Union database. Books, thesis, serials. I'll just put some search. Experimental theory, title, exact search. So these are the books available. Experimental biology. This is Union Catalog. When you click here, it will show the detail, author, place, publication, and agency. This book is available in Punjab University. So this is how we can check. You can cite it also, you can download it also. But this is only the for citation and for searching the book. If you are serious researchers and books are not available anywhere, you can search this database. And you can ask this university to give the book on interlibrary loan. Okay. MHRD initiatives. That Swayam is also a part of that project only. All the MOOC online courses are available. See. स्वयं मासिव ओपन ऑनलाइन कोर्सेज, नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी और ई कंटेंट, ई पीजी पाठशाला, शोध गंगा, ई शोध सिंधु. आई विल शो यू वन बाय वन ऑल स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल वर्चुअल लैब्स दैट आई हैव जस्ट शोड यू वर्चुअल लैब्स. सो दीज ऑल आर द MHRD इनिशिएटिव्स. दिस लिंक हैज ऑल्सो गिवन इन लाइब्रेरी पेज ऑन क्यू अंडर क्यूक एक्सेस. सो नो नीड टू रिमेंबर ऑल द URLs ऑल द टाइम. You can just click here, there, and you just reach in this website. National Digital Library of India. This is created by IITs. So many subjects are there. Topic of the week, talks and webinar. Person of the week, on this day, birth centenary, scholarly publication and documents, video, journals, conferences, ideas and funding, challenges, startup. Just take this subject, law. So all the full text, audio, video, articles, conference proceedings, books, everything is available under NDLI. It will take a lot of time. Okay. See, bulk registration is also available under NDLI. So all the college students can take this membership. If we send the data in Excel sheet, all the students' data, they will create bulk registration for all the students' user. And then they can start using all this online material. Right now also it is free. They can individually also download on the mobile app and then they can access it. But if we go through the institutional and create the data for all the students, that gives weightage to our institution also. Shodh Ganga, this is for thesis and dissertation, only for the Indian electronic thesis and dissertation data. But colleges cannot take the membership of this Shodh Ganga. We have to go through university only. So if University of Mumbai is the member of this, if anybody is doing research under University of Mumbai, then while submitting his research, that soft copy will be uploaded through the University of Mumbai by this website, Shodh Ganga. And that thesis is available, free full text. You can search the thesis. This is the data, University of Madras, Savitribai Phule University, they have submitted 10,518, Aligarh Muslim University. So this is the data of electronic thesis, and you can enter thesis number also if you know, and you can search. I just search if any of thesis is there related to English literature. See, I have just put a search on English literature. So these are the theses available. This is the recent one, 16 June 2020. If you want to check this research, free full text PDF is available. Title, certificate, declaration, content page, chapter wise. So you can download each and everything full free. Chapter wise also you can download. Bibliography also you can download. If it is relevant, somewhat similar to your PhD area, you can download some 3-4 research and then you can take some references from that. So this will be very useful for those who are doing research. EPG Pathshala. This is also MHRD initiative. I am showing all the free resources which you can use very well. EPG Pashala, this is created for all the PG students, PG subjects. So you just explore it. These are the subjects. You can check any of the subjects. You will get the material. This will help you preparing online content. While you prepare, you can take reference from there. See this. So e-text and self-learning material is there. So if you click on e-text, you can download this. And e-text will be available. If you just click on self-learning, then the video will come. You can listen the video. So this is how you can use this EPG Pathshala. So many books are available, audio and video. EPG Pathshala, E-Pathshala, as some of the junior college teachers are also there. So this E-Pathshala is for junior teachers. They can join as a students, teacher, educator, or as a parents. You can access e-resources through QR code that will be given in the book. As a teacher, if you check e-resources, here you can select audio or video. If you want audio or video, you can select language. You can select the level also. We want senior secondary, that is for 12th standard. And then filter it, you will get some material. So these type of videos, so hundreds of videos, you will get it. I'll just show you one. So these videos also, you can use in your teaching learning. Spoken tutorial. This site is developed by IITs, and all the technical and this computer science programming languages are here, but some of the other subjects are also there. If we take Digital India, let's see, English. See, you will get this video, SBI account opening. PMJJBY. So if they have given the videos how to open the SBI account. So you can just explore it, all the subjects, and you'll get to know. Lot of materials are available. You can join any of the exams, and for the certification, you'll have to pay the fees. Otherwise, material is free. E Bal Bharati, this is also all the books are available, free full text. Download PDF books. All the class 12, from first standard to 12th standard, all the books are available, free full text. You can download any of the book and then you can use it. So you can tell the students also to download any of the book. They can read online. See, if you download the book, ebooks, there is always an option that you can put some highlight. These features will always come. So you can draw, you can erase, you can take print, you can save it. See. I'll show you some. See. Here you can put some mark, you can highlight, yeah. And then you just save it this way, okay. You can erase it also. You can save. So once you, and then you save it with the highlights and with the marking. So explore this type and tell your students also. pdfdrive.com. On this site, you will get almost this number keep increasing, 8,36,00,000 books on this site. That is free full text available. You just highlight any of the book, you can check any of the book and then download this. And this also written here that how many downloads of this book is there. So these many downloads of this book. See this. If you can download this many times, they have downloaded the book. If you download the book, again the same features will come that you can highlight and you can read online. So you just explore this. Marathi books are also there on that, and even the Hindi books are also available. Lot of Hindi books are available there. This Marathi books. This is also full downloadable. This book is 3,813 times they have downloaded. So check out this. The same way Hindi books on pdfdrive.net. So here also you can select some of the books and give the list to the students that this book is available on this site and students can read it. Polybooks.com, this site is also very good. Here all the religious books are available if you have interest to read any of the religion book. And then plus the biographies. So if you are interested of any of the biographies, you can download and read this book. These are the biographies. Okay. NOPR.niskaya.rec.in. This is online periodical repository and maximum of the journals listed here are there in the UGC care list. See, these are the journals. And this is free, full text available. You can search, click here, this Indian Journal of Biochemistry, Biophysics. This is specially for science subjects. Okay. See, from 1984 onwards, this book is available, this magazine is available, journal free full text. If you check out 2020, you will get this detail. April 2020 is the last journal. And this is the content page of it. You can check any of the paper, you can download it, you can refer, you can cite it for your references. See, view and open in PDF. You can save it very well. Yeah, that's. And maximum of the journals available here in this NISCARE are listed in UGC CARE. These are authentic resources. These are the journals. Content management tools. Some of the content management tools, Microsoft Word references. Microsoft Word will take care of your content, how to manage. If you're writing any book, you can prepare table of contents, update table, you can insert the footnotes, you can insert citation, insert bibliography. So this is how that Microsoft Word will take care if you're writing a book. You can insert the footnotes also, give the references also. another reference tool is Mendeley and Zotero. Mendeley can be accessible through mobile, that app is there, and Zotero is accessible through PC or desktop only. So these two are also tool. I have downloaded both in my PC, so that is why it is reflecting here, Mendeley, and then here is Zotero. So whatever the research paper, I will search in any of the site, that button will come on this Zotero, and I'll save my search on this Zotero and prepare the citation. Plagiarism checker tool. So there are some paid software, Urkun, Turnitin, Drillbit. We are going to take this Drillbit software in our library very soon. And these are the free Dupli checker, plagiarism checker, PlagScan, CopyLeaks. You can check out all the features. Some are available only for 100 downloads, for 100 papers or 1,000 words. So these are the limitations with the free one. How to use UGC care list. This last week, this list was not accessible. Just 2 days ago, they have activated the list with the updated version. Individual members have to create your login to check this list. You have to log in because I have already logged in. And they have found out some list of clone journals. So when you want to publish your paper, you just please check out this clone journal also. Otherwise, this will not be suitable for, it will not give weightage on the CAS when you submit your paper in these clone journals. They have divided this UGC care list group 1 and group 2. If you search the list, see, these are the journals available here under science, social science, indexed in Scopus. This is updated list. Here it is written discontinued from July 2020. That means you cannot download the UGC care list of full journals. This list is keep on updating always, all the time. So whenever you want to submit the paper, you just check it on which date, or you just have to take the screenshot and that on this date, this journal was listed, and now after that, they discontinue. If you can view any of the journals, then you'll get the detail of it. All the journals detail. So directly, if you want to publish, you can go from that site, care list, to that journal publication site. You can search here with the title wise. I just put this search, explore. This is St. Xavier's Research Journal listed in UGC care list. So these issues have come. If you want to publish your paper in this, so you can go ahead because this is listed in UGC care. So this is how you can search UGC care list. You have to prepare individual login ID only, and it keeps on updating always all the time. Resources, check this. Some of the resources are available here. You can also suggest resources to online form. There is an online form. If some of the resources you want to be added here, so you can suggest to UGC care list team and they will add this. Author AID. This is global network of researchers. This is a very good social platform of all the active researchers in all the areas. If you subscribe their email, then if you sign in and then you subscribe the email, they will give you the details of all the activities going on there. And you can put your this paper also, and all the latest videos, discussions, on the current topics, you will get it here. Even the research funding is also available here. Some of the mentoring you can, if you are doing some big project, you can ask some resources, some faculty members, other universities to help you in this. Okay. MD College at Institutional Repository. We have this repository 2 years before, but now due to that IP address change and some technical problem, this repository is not available. And I have just again to download this data is gone now. It is not there. But again, we have to create this repository. DSpace materials can go in institutional repository. So we can put all the technical reports, all the working paper, conference paper, e-thesis, audio, video, statistical report, images, visual materials. This is within the institution. All the institutional members show us that work through this institutional repository. This repository can be online, can be on intranet. What will be the benefit for the faculty members if they put their paper here? Greater citation, preservation, easy of use, and there is a permanent place. DSpace is free for institutional. Scholarly material produced by the college is available in one place. Both scholarly and non-scholarly are also preserved for future use. Material, this is not traditionally published, is included in the repository. You can add the newsletter also, and some small reports, students' projects also under this institutional repository. And this is a marketing tool of our institution. Google Books, when you create this Gmail ID, Gmail is always open when you use this. If your Gmail account is open and you search any of the book, that you can save all the searches here to read, reading now, have read. You can create the folders also, my history. Under favorites, I put 10 books under favorites. So when I will get time, I'll just check it out. So I'll just search it and I'll put it. So these are the Google Books. You can manage it. IndiaStat.com. Earlier, we have this database 1 year, but somehow it was not usable by any of the faculty members. So we have to just discontinue this database. It is very expensive. But whatever free content is available, this is authentic and it gives socioeconomic statistical information about data. So if you're preparing any e-content, you can take definitely this data, because this is authentic source. You will get lot of data here under education, but only because we have not subscribed, you cannot get the detailed tables and everything. For that, they require login ID and password. See here. So till that, you can use this. This is the India population, world population. And publication, some of the publication announcement, if any of the institutions, member institution of IndiaStat.com are arranging some of the conference, they will announce it here. The World Bank also subscribe this. And these are the latest titles, articles are available, which is authentic. Baxter.com. This also we have taken from the library for our teachers. 50 users package we have taken, but later on nobody have used it, so we discontinue. This is accessible in the desktop also and the Android phone also. The app is available. And when you subscribe, you can access all the newspapers and all 5,000 magazines, you can access it. So once you subscribe this logo, this is gold access. You can open it and you can read full magazine online. You can select the magazine also. You don't want all these 5,000 magazines in your list. So you can select one or two or three, four magazines in your list, favorite list. And whatever new books, new magazine will come, it will display on your app and you can read it. Copyright free images. We prepare a lot of content by copying from the internet, but we'll have to check the copyright issue also. When I just search a digital marketing, then you go to tools and then you just click it here, uses right. Not filtered by license, labeled for reuse with modification. So you can just click it here, labeled for non-commercial reuse with modification. That means I just want some of the images and I wanted to reuse with some modification. So I just show you some example. So always search this and then see this one image I just save it and I put the information in that and I can reuse it, this image. This is the same image that also I have just put this stay online, stay safe, and I've made color changes. So this also I can use it freely without copyright issue. Some of the mobile apps are there. So this I have already showed you, this one, Epathshala Swayam, this booklet app. This is booklet app. I will show in mobile this booklet app. Can you see? See, this is booklet app. And I'm reading this book, so I'm not finished. So that is why it's 35%. And this also, I have not read full. And these books are come in part 1, 2, 3. And there is one icon here, voice. So if you don't want to read, if you want to listen, you just click it here. And I'll just show you one here. The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. I just wanted to listen that book.
Julian Mantle, a lawyer with a Ferrari. This is the story of Julian Mantle, a man who, in anyone else's eyes, had it all.
Yeah. So instead of reading, you can listen also. This is very good app. Interactive videos. You can download any of the videos and put interactive for your teaching learning purpose. I just show you a small example. This must be the last my slide. This is one video where I put some instruction. I add this. This is a
tutorial. Hello friends, welcome to. And we type here YouTube audio library pre-download.
And see, I add this question here in this video. I just pause the video and I add the question for the students. YouTube videos are copyright free. If answer is free, then you get the point. Okay. Now again, this.
We click on, or we are creating some video for a. So here we see.
See this
music.
I just add no more about copyrights. So I've just stopped that video there, and I give this URL that if you want to check out further about this copyright law, they will give it here. Go to here. Okay.
Or available here, alternative and punk. Gambian children's domestic classical country, whatever we need, use references in our research papers. We will 32 attribution not required. We may choose attribution required if you choose any song from those types of video audio. If you want MB.
Here I put a question.
And if I no.
I just add one question here. In between, I pause the video and put a question and ask the student to give the answer.
Okay. To anyone.
So in the end, it gives the result.
Sports. And you must also include this in your work. Thank you very much.
Oh, I've just give the answer of two questions. And this is how you can prepare the interactive videos. You can prepare your video also, or you can download and add the interaction in between. Library on social media, you can check on our library blog, Twitter page, Facebook page, and YouTube anytime. These are the QR code for can access through your smartphone, library catalog, website, institutional repository. Learning is the only thing the mind never exhausts, never fears, and never regrets. And thank you.
Dhanyavad, madam.
Thank you.
Vinita, nice. It was very nice presentation. Presentation.
Thank you, madam.
Very nice.
We got to know quite a lot of things. Really wonder. My God, so much is there. Yeah. We are not aware of.
Vinita, can we access any book from home?
Yes, yes.
I mean, not the title. In even the books matter inside.
Yeah, that pdfdrive.net. No, you can access all the books over there. You can download it also.
We need. We can sit at home and take a book and just go through.
Yeah.
And that PDF be converted into Word. So if you want to use any matter out of that for notes.
Yeah, you can try to convert. If it is not copyright, you can convert it online.
Okay, online we can convert.
Yeah. Just search it to Word to PDF or PDF to Word converter, and then okay. Put your book over there. It will convert online.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. But before Usha madam takes over, I would like to request everyone that as Vinita madam has presented, we all should register ourselves under Vidwan.
Yeah.
This is request to everyone to please register under Vidwan and use InflipNet, because that data is generated automatically and we really cannot.
Yeah, this data is really
bad for them. Hello. There is one question.
Yeah, okay, ask.
Yeah, Vinita madam, you just showed that two questions were added in between. Okay, in last few slides, yeah. You showed addition of questions.
Yeah.
So how those questions are added, how that can be added?
This is like inside H5 tools, H5P tools. So there you have to create your login ID and that you can download any of the video, YouTube video, and put your questions over there. So there is an option in that software, H5P2.
Okay.
So there
you little can disturbance, madam. Yeah. Little disturbance is there.
You can put your discussion also. You can put another YouTube videos also. You can put your quiz also to give the answer by the student. So you can keep in a video and that will go up to 1 hour full session. You keep engaging the students.
Okay. Thank you, madam. There is one more question put by Kavita madam, how to get login and password. I think library had provided it to everyone.
Yeah, at least. We have provided and we have given a link to library page also.
Yeah.
We have added. Those who did not get it, you just submit that form and we'll get it again.
Okay, so Kavita madam and all others who still have not used that login and password, you can make use of that.
and contact Vinita madam on library email ID.
You cannot create twice that login ID password.
Yeah.
If they forget the password, they just log in it with your email address and then click on forget password. So that password will generate in their email ID. You verify the email and you can again start using NList. We will create one more form to submit your e-contents so that all the e-contents will come under our repository. Right now, everybody is creating their own YouTube channel and all other separate contents. But once we create institutional repository, everybody will save the contents over there, and that will be available at one place.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, एक और question है. Yes. Ma'am, is the login ID available for junior college teachers as
yes,
well?
Yes, 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 definitely. We can create 10,000 user ID at a time. For all the students, all the teachers, everybody can make use of it. Even okay. The NDLI also, National Digital Library. That also okay. Can create.
That will be a great resource, na, NDLI, yes. If we try for.
Can create bulk.
That will be great.
Registration.
Okay, thank you so much.
I am also, you just encourage the students to take one course every year. So, of course. That give weightage during NIRF ranking. That so many students have taken MOOC courses.
Yeah, yeah.
To our institution.
Ma'am, एक प्रश्न और है. Ma'am, what about ResearchGate? Can it be freely available without login?
No, you have to log in through the institutional email address. It is social networking, academic social networking. You have to log in through institutional, wherever your address mtcollege.in, then only you can log in it. Your personal account, you cannot log in it. So whoever is having a institutional email address, they can log in ResearchGate. Some of the teachers are there on the
ResearchGate. Okay, ma'am. मैं आज के रिसोर्स पर्सन का धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करती हूँ डॉक्टर विनीता जैन मैडम का कि उन्होंने हमें उपयोगी एवं महत्वपूर्ण जानकारी प्रदान की. हम वास्तव में अपने टीचिंग लर्निंग में इन सारे सोर्सेज का उपयोग करेंगे. मैं हमारे प्राचार्य मैडम का धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करती हूँ कि वे लगातार इस कोशिश में हैं कि हम अपने लेक्चर को कैसे बेहतरीन से बेहतरीन बनाएं ताकि विद्यार्थियों का इसका लाभ मिल सके. मैं IQSC कोऑर्डिनेटर वैशाली मैडम का धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करती हूँ कि इस तरह के आयोजन की वे लगातार पहल कर रही हैं. सभी प्रतिभागियों का आभार. आपने पूरे धैर्य से अपनी सहभागिता इतने दिनों तक बनाए रखी. टेक्निकल सपोर्ट के लिए अयपन जी का धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करती हूँ कि वे अपना समय समय पर सहयोग देते रहे हैं. आप सभी का एक बार